Welcome students, last video we have studied about communicable diseases, now we will continue with non-communicable diseases. So what is non-communicable diseases? Diseases that are not caused by pathogens and are not infectious are called non-communicable diseases. Not infectious, but communicable disease, it is infectious, it can be transferred. Here these diseases cannot be transferred. So they may occur due to deficiency of certain nutrients in the diet or due to malfunction of certain organs because of old age or problems in metabolism. So they are broadly grouped under nutritional deficiency diseases, allergies, organ malfunction diseases, bites and stings. So we will discuss little elaborately. First is nutritional deficiency diseases. So this occurs due to lack of specific nutrients in the diet cause deficiency disease. If a person does not eat sufficient quantity of balanced food, she or he is said to be undernourished. So see here. So these are three children sitting. This is a C, child affecting with kwashiorkor. It's a disease. Then see healthy child, and this is the child affected with marasmus. So these are two diseases and this is the healthy child. So you can see the structure, how they look because they are not getting an inadequate amount, they are getting inadequate amount or lack of specific nutrients. Okay. So first see protein energy malnutrition. It is a condition in young children between 1 to 5 years affected by the deficiency of proteins or carbohydrates and fats, or all of these in their diet. Either one or all the three, they are having less amount of, they are not getting proper amount of these proteins, carbohydrates and fats. Okay. It may lead to two diet diseases, that is kwashiorkor and marasmus. See, this is kwashiorkor and this is the marasmus. Then kwashiorkor symptoms is stunted growth and mental retardation, frequent diarrhea, water retention, oedema, bulging eyes, protruding belly, thin stick-like legs, okay, discoloration of hair. Hair will not look black color. Then, marasmus, it occurs when children below 1 year do not get adequate amount of proteins and carbohydrates. They show the following symptoms, that is prominent ribs, dry, thin and wrinkled skin, mental retardation, lean and weak body. Then about vitamin and mineral deficiency diseases. So these diseases, these vitamins and minerals are needed in very small quantities to ensure proper functioning of various processes. Okay, it is required very small quantities. Okay, and see, these are the vitamins A, B, B12, C, D, E, K. And the disease cause night blindness. This vitamin A deficiency causes night blindness. Deficiency vitamin B deficiency causes beriberi. Like this, B12 anemia, C scurvy, D rickets, E skin, K excessive bleeding. So, and these are the sources. If you will eat these foods, then you will not have those diseases. If deficiency of such foods cause such diseases. Okay. Similarly, here minerals. Minerals like calcium, phosphorus, iron, sodium, iodine, potassium, chlorine. Okay, these if you will take less or intake is not in, it is not adequate, then the diseases will be rickets, bad teeth and bones, anemia, muscular cramps. See here, this calcium, rickets, phosphorus, bad teeth and bones, iron, anemia, sodium, muscular cramps, then iodine, goiter symptoms is enlargement of thyroid gland, then potassium, muscular weakness, paralysis, chlorine, weakness, dehydration. So the vitamins and minerals are also very important. Then organ malfunction disease, or you can say is degenerative disease. Why? Because it affects the organ. Certain health issues or diseases caused due to malfunctioning of some body organs such as heart, kidney, pancreas as a result of impaired metabolism or improper hormonal secretions. Some common organ malfunction disorders are diabetes, heart and renal problems. Diabetes, blood sugar level, heart, you know, then renal problems is related to kidney. So first one is diabetes mellitus. It is caused by inadequate secretion of insulin by pancreas. Insulin regulates the level of glucose in the blood by helping the liver to convert excess glucose into glycogen and store it. So what happened? Now when the body produces glucose in the blood, and what liver is to convert the excess glucose, whatever the excess glucose is there, whatever utilized glucose in the body, okay, then after excess glucose is stored in the liver in the form of glycogen. In diabetic patient, the body can neither use sugar nor store in the liver. So when the person is affected with diabetes, then what happened? This liver cannot store any sugar. So what will happen? This sugar, extra sugar, this blood, it will store in the blood. Okay, so like this diabetes persons get affected. The diabetes can lead to malfunction of other organs such as kidney and heart. So it affects to kidney and the heart. Next is heart disease. So two types of disease, coronary heart disease and heart attack. So disorders of the heart and blood vessels are directly related to diet and the way of living. A sedentary lifestyle, fat rich diet, the diet which contains excess fats, okay, leading to weight gain and stress are major causes of heart malfunctions. Okay, if a person is in stress or used to eat fat rich diet, then only it can have these two diseases. Coronary heart disease, it occurs when the heart muscles do not get enough oxygen. Then heart attack. Coronary artery disease, that is CAD, CAD, leads to a heart attack. It occurs when a part of the heart muscle is suddenly deprived of its blood supply. Okay, and due to complete blockage in the artery feeding it. So this causes heart attack. So these are the two heart diseases. The renal disease. Renal is related to kidney. This occurs when the kidney are unable to efficiently filter waste such as urea, uric acid, water and salts. Thus, they get accumulated in the blood, preventing the removal of additional wastage from the cells. Patients with malfunctioning kidneys need periodic dialysis to remove the kidney, to remove waste or kidney transplant. So, dialysis is the process to remove the waste. Okay, or the person can do kidney transplants. Then, arthritis. Arthritis is a disease of joints. It is two types, that is rheumatoid arthritis and osteoarthritis. See, this is rheumatoid arthritis related to the stiffness in the joint, especially on the fingers. And this osteoarthritis, it is because of the hereditary. Okay, it is caused by breakdown, eventual degeneracy of cartilage of the joints due to aging, because of aging, then heredity or injury. It is marked by stiffness or pain in affected in joints such as hips, knees, spine. But here in rheumatoid arthritis, middle of the joints, okay, which may get twisted. See, these fingers are twisted. And see, this is osteoarthritis, this is affecting the joints. Then, cancer. It is defined as uncontrolled growth of the abnormal cells in any part of the body that invades normal tissue. So, here in the diagram, see, these are the normal tissue and this is the uncontrolled growth of the cells. Okay. A growing mass of cancerous cells is called the malignant tumor. Cancers are generally named after the organ in which they originate. So, depend upon the organ, so it has been given which type of cancer it is. Like it is, if in the bone, then it is bone cancer, like that. Or it, if the blood, these cancer cells are found in the blood, then it is blood cancer. Okay. Then an allergy is an unusual hypersensitivity of body tissue or certain substances. The substance that trigger an allergy are called the allergens. That trigger an allergy, okay, the substance, these are called allergens. They may be food, drugs, cosmetics, dust, pollen grains or perfumes. Asthma, eczema and hives are some of the disease caused allergic reactions. So in the diagram, see, this is the allergy cause redness in the skin. Then bites and stings. Bites and stings of certain animals, insects such as snakes, spiders and canines are caused by can cause great discomfort. Okay, snakes, you know, they are very poisonous. Spiders also. Then canines, teeth of some animals. Okay, For example, the bite of poisonous snake can be fatal if not treated promptly, that is soon. Poisonous snakes contain venom which affects the nervous circulatory system. Then fever. Fever is not a disease but an indicative of a disease. Okay, fever occurs when person suffers from a disease or an infection. Then only symptoms fever is there. Okay, the normal temperature of the human beings is considered to be 98.4 degree or 37 degree centigrade. If the temperature in the body rise or fall, then this standard temperature, then only it is termed as fever. So rise in body temperature above 105 degree centigrade, that is 98.4 is normal. So if it is more than 105, then it is fever, and below 96 degree Fahrenheit are both dangerous. If the temperature less also dangerous and rise also dangerous. So rise in temperature is the fever. Then comes cleanliness and hygiene. So cleanliness, many diseases can be avoided by maintaining the cleanliness and hygiene within and around yourself and by taking simple precautions such as personal hygiene. How we will take personal, how one can do personal hygiene? By taking care of skin, hands and hair, oral hygiene, mouth, then eye care, eyes. Okay. So personal hygiene is the practice of keeping yourself clean. Following a few good habits, you can keep yourself clean. Like the care of skin, hands and hair, bathe regularly, wear clean clothes, wash hands, then wash your hair, massage your hair, combing hair, keep your nails trimmed and clean to avoid germs and dirt. So go through these points. Okay, habits, good habits. Then oral hygiene. Oral hygiene involves keeping the mouth and teeth clean and avoiding tooth decay. How we can avoid tooth decay? By brushing your teeth, eating crunchy vegetables. Why? Because they scrub your teeth. Then making milk, cheese, curd a part of your daily diet because they are rich in calcium and makes bones and teeth strong. Avoid excess of chocolates and toffees. Then eye care. Eye are the most delicate of your sense organs. Then you need to protect them from dust and infections such as conjunctivitis and trachoma. These are the diseases. Then eating vegetables such as spinach, carrot, cabbage, fruits, mango, papaya is good for the eyes. Eyes have their natural defense mechanism. How? Like eyelashes protect from the dust and dirt. Tears help out the dirt and eyelids close when any object gets too close to the eyes. Then community hygiene. Only keeping personal hygiene is not okay. We have to make our environment also clean. A clean environment helps people to stay healthy. Apart from maintaining personal hygiene, you must keep your surroundings clean. All programs and activities aimed at improving public health come under community health or community hygiene, like provision of safe drinking water, disposal of waste and their treatment. Panchayat in villages and municipalities in towns are responsible for such type of programs. Then provision of safe drinking water. How the water can be saved? By adding chlorine tablets which kills the microorganisms, then using alum crystals. Okay, this also alum can settle the fine solid particles which can be filtered because the water is muddy and need to be clear. So alum crystals are used. Then sedimentation, storing water in store cans and earthen pots which remove suspended impurities in water by allowing them to settle down. This process is called sedimentation. Then boiling. Boiling kills the germs. Okay, boiling of water. Then using water filters or RO. RO is the reverse osmosis. Okay, these days filters with techniques such as porous carbon candles, passing ultraviolet UV radiation through water, reverse osmosis RO systems, and also some enablers to get free germ water. So these are the methods for drinking safe pure water. Then disposal of waste and treatment. So proper disposal of waste and their treatments contributes to clean surroundings, to overall public health. It is responsibility of civic bodies to ensure proper collection of waste from household, office, industries and other places. So such methods are sewage disposal and treatment. Then garbage collection, dumping, then composting. Okay, so sewage disposal and treatment. See, wastewater from the kitchens and toilets of house and other places are carried through underground sewers. Then most cities have treatment plants to sewage before allowing them to flow into the water bodies. Directly they are not sending the waste to the water bodies, they are having a treatment. So see, this is sewage treatment plants. Like this, big cities and all, they used to follow, do such treatment, okay, to make the environment clean. Then garbage collection and dumping. Civic bodies also make arrangement for the collection of garbage and its proper disposal. If it is then dumped in the pits in low lying area situated away from the human habitation. Okay, when full, these pits are covered by soil so that garbage cannot be scattered by animals. And these places, sometimes they are made into parks, converted into parks, shopping malls and other buildings on these dumping grounds after many years. Then composting. Kitchen and garden waste can be decomposed naturally by dumping it into pits covered with soil. Microorganisms present in the soil decompose this waste into manure-rich soil or compost. In the diagram, this is, see, it is a compost pit. Okay, here all things are deposited. Then this method is called composting. Then sometimes what happens? Sometimes earthworms are added to these pits. Okay. To speed up the process of decomposition of waste into compost. This is called vermi composting. With this chapter completed. Read the chapters properly. Thank you.